Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see what is moving averages in DAX. So basically, moving average is like when you're having continuous data and you want to sum up and divide by that particular month. Say for example, 3 months moving average, 2 months moving average, or weekly moving average. Like that, you want to compute and you want to display it in you want to see against what is your total sales. Without wasting time, let us try to jump into a demo. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI and DAX. So let us try to explain what is this. So we have a data here from 2016 and keep on going. So today we will focus on 3 months moving average, like the one you are seeing here. So you see like January, February, March, and say for example, you want to compute this for 3 months average. So January, February, March, then the average will be the 3 months average. When you move to April, the average should be February, March, April, and it should be displayed here. What I'm trying to say, I have copied this data over here, and you see the average of January is nothing but you cannot have a previous 2 months or 3 months, so it will be the same. And when you come to February, it will be 150. I mean, you see here 155775. When you sum up March, it should be 161150. When you come to April, you should not sum the, you should not consider January. It should be these 3 months, April, March, February. That is moving average. It should be 16000. You see the average here. When you come to May, it should be May, April, March. There is a formula here. So today I'm going to focus on differently. Instead of writing a DAX manually, you already aware of this option that is quick measure. Let us try to write over using a quick measure. So this is the total sales I have here, and typically go to total sales. It cannot be a no need to be total sales. If you have, that will be better. There is option called new quick measure, right? You can click on it. People are not exploring this option because lot of analysis you can do it on based on this quick measure that you need to write more and do, that you need to think. So today it's a rolling average, it's not a moving or rolling average. So basically, so let us try to check this one, rolling average, and this is based on total sales. That's why I clicked on this particular measure, otherwise you need to choose and choose the date column. Okay, now as we said, it is a period of 3 months, so how many months you want. So here it should be very carefully chosen, like what you want. You want 3 months from the today, right? So here you can see number of periods to average before each date, okay, including that particular period, including that. So you give 2 here. If you want 3 months average, you give 2 here, and periods after. So number of periods to average after each date. So after that period also you want average, that is not required. So make it as 0 here. So including that particular month, and then you go back 2 months, that is it covers 3 months average. Okay, so based on that you can change it here. If you want 6 months, you can give 5 here, something like that. So click on OK now. So that is a measure created here, rolling month average 3. Let us try to see the results. Okay, I hope this is giving us same result like when you see April, that is April, March, February, that we have seen in Excel here. April, March, February, the average is 16600. And when you come to May, when you sum it up May, April and March, it is 16641. Let us try to see here, 166417. That is perfectly all right. So let us try to understand the formula. That gives us a good result, that is whatever expected. Let us try to understand this formula first. So this is the query generated by Power BI, then when you write a quick measure, that is so complex to understand, right? So let me walk through it. So total sales, this is the name, and if it is filtered by dim date, then you throw error, okay? That is, you should not filter by date, that is why it is giving you error. If it is not, okay, then only you perform all these operations, that is average, what we are doing. Basically, you need to get end of month of each row, okay, end of month. Then you need to go 3 months back from the date, okay. That is, what is the logic basically? See, right now we are, now let us try to understand logic. Now we are in May, so what is the logic? Get this date, that is end of month of this particular date, that is May 30th, 2016. Then that is should be a first parameter should be saved. Then go back 3 months, okay. Then get the starting of this month, okay. Then this is the logic. So you sum up these three, then divide by three. That is the, or you do the average of you that particular period. So basically, you are getting the month, that is end of this month, beginning of this month. Then you sum up these three or average these three values. That is the logic. Okay, that is what it is explained here. So we are getting the end of that month for that May. Then the date period, you are getting the entire period. It is not getting the end starting period, but you are saying here dates between dim date dot date, start of month of date add of minus 2 of the month. Okay, so you go 2 months back and get that starting of the month. Okay, that is what it has written, and this variable contain the list of dates, and you get the last date. Last date is nothing but the end of the month. So basically you get list of dates, that is 3 months period, and stored in this variable. That is the second step. Then you perform the average X of calculate table. You summarize the values based on the dim date, because you may use any different kind of dates. It can be a year, quarter, or a month. So you summarize it, okay, and keep it in a one single table kind of thing, calculated table. Then use this period here. This acts as a filter to this particular calculation. Then you do the total sales, okay. Then on top of that, you wrap it around with average X. So you filter the 3 months for the each row, then you perform the average X of total six. That is what it is doing. So I hope this is very clear. This is the moving average, but the same logic we have already written in our video, like 3 months cumulative average. Let me explain this simple formula over here. What we did, so basically the same thing like the way it has initiated. When you consider a month, you need to get the period of 3 months, right? So for that, instead of dates between, I have used dates in period, dim date dot date, and last date of dim date dot date. This is to get the, for this particular row, the last date is nothing but November 30th. Then you go back 3 months, okay, 3 months back, okay, dates in period. Dates in period also generates the date. Then you get this sum. Then for getting the dates, okay, number of months, what I am using, same calculation, dates in period, dim date dot date, last date of dim date minus 3 months, get the distinct count of the month, okay, divided by how many months we are. So now we have 3 here, so that's why it's 3. If it is 6 months cumulative, you change this minus 3 over here with minus 6. Then you do the divide. Average is nothing but sum divided by your number of number of period, right? It is 3 months here, so you divide it here. This is another way of doing it. So you see here, dates in period, you get the sum and total for 3 months. This is another way of doing it. Let us try to view this measure as well. So you see both are giving the same results everywhere. It is same. So your calculation, it depends. So basically, if you go for a quick measure, it will give you always a correct results. And if you do your own calculation, there might be some issues in your data that may not be perfect. So all scenarios, it will be handled in your calculated quick measures. The way it has written is very neat and organized. Okay, it's up to you which one to go. So and how you need to visualize, basically it is used to visualize in a line and bar chart combination, like over here, so that you can see the trend. Basically, whether if it is the average is going down, really down, then you can immediately react. So you need to always see as an average, moving average. That is the main purpose of moving averages, how you are performing. Not only you are looking at only for a few days, like I mean, if it is compared with this particular period, you cannot suddenly say it is declined. So if you see with average, this is fine, like that. So that is the base concept behind moving averages. I hope you guys like this video, and if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe to learn the concepts in DAX, and share and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.